Minnesota has a lot of lakes, but it probably has even more aquariums. On their own, each are great, but when they mix, there can be some unintended consequences. The plants and animals that we keep in our aquariums pose a significant threat to the health of Minnesota's lakes, ponds, wetlands, and streams. It is never a good idea to dump the plants and animals that we keep in aquariums into the wild. This goes for native species as well, because aquariums can be a source of disease that can be transferred from the pet fish to the wild fish. There are a few species of particular concern in the aquarium trade. The DNR keeps a list of prohibited species on its website. The common ones that we see, and in Bloomington as well, are goldfish and koi. Goldfish are hardy enough to survive Minnesota winters, and that means they're able to take over the ponds and lakes that they're released into. And like carp, they root around in the bottom and they kick up the sediment. That makes the water more dirty. That, in turn, harms native fish. And there are some ways to get goldfish and koi out of wild waters, but they're pretty labor-intensive and expensive, and they're also not perfect. So even if you have a few individuals left over after removal, they can take back over in a few years. The best way to prevent goldfish from getting into Minnesota waters is to not release them in the first place. Now, if you have an unwanted fish, or if you have aquariums that you just don't want to keep anymore, the plants, the snails, the fish themselves, do not dump them into the wild. A good strategy is to contact your local pet store or aquarium supplier. They may take the fish from you, or they can at least help you dispose of it properly. And with your help, we can protect Minnesota's waters for many years to come.